Hello friends, welcome back. Today we will be dealing with some sick Phalaenopsis orchids. I have 5 of these mini phals that I ordered recently as a discounted combo. So as expected, these are not in optimal health. 3 of them are quite okay, while 2 of them seem to be having some sort of infection in their leaves. This one is more severely affected. The bottom leaf is completely yellow, and this is not normal yellowing of the bottom leaves. You can see some wet spots here and there. That means it's infection of some sorts. Now let's check the other leaves. This one has some spots near the tip, and this one has several spots scattered almost all over. I'm no expert in this, but in my experience of growing orchids, I definitely can tell this is a fungal infection, and if not treated, the whole leaf will be affected in no time. These yellow spots, they will multiply, they will merge, and they will affect the whole leaf, and the whole plant will be affected if not treated in the right time. These spots, they start as tiny blackish brownish spots in the leaves surrounded by a yellow halo. The halo suggests that the infection is spreading. It had crown rot, you can see this portion, but somehow it's healed, it's dry, and most probably after that the orchid produced this keiki in response to that. It couldn't grow any further because of the rot, so it produced a keiki from the side. Now coming back to the leaf problems, they occur due to extremely humid water logging conditions if the water is left to sit on the leaves for too long, and these also spread from one plant to another through our hands or by splashing of water or through unsterile equipments. Let's not waste any time and get to the treatment part. I have my scissors, a disinfectant spray to disinfect those, and I have cinnamon powder with me and 3% hydrogen peroxide. I have cleaned my hands. First I will unpot this one. It's in this tight moss plug, which again is not desirable. Moss is okay for orchids when used properly, but not in this fashion. However, the roots don't look that bad. I will remove the moss from around the roots. If some remain stuck, then don't worry. You can remove that when you are cleaning the roots with water. Don't pull anything violently. I will remove the ones that feel mushy or those that feel empty, papery or stringy. Healthy roots will feel firm to touch. Be careful, each and every root is very important. Now with my sterile scissors, I will go ahead and cut the dead decaying roots. Now let's get to the leaves. I have sterilized my scissors again. Now I'll start with the less affected leaves and then go to the heavily infected one. This one here has just a few spots near the tip, so quite easy. I will cut into the healthy tissue, leaving at least a good margin of around 1 to 2 cm. By leaving a margin of healthy tissue, we are making sure that if at all there are any microscopic tiny spots or foci of infection which we can't see with our naked eyes, we are removing those as well. Next is this leaf. It has many scattered spots, but the leaf is firm and is still green. I will try to salvage at least a little portion of the leaf. So I will cut somewhere here and remove all the spots and leave a margin of healthy tissue. So only a tiny bit of leaf will remain. Next is this yellow leaf. I will cut as close as to the stem as possible. Remove the whole thing. In fact, I will peel off the remaining portion from the stem. Now I will go clean the whole orchid under running tap water. I have removed the paper with old media and cut leaves and cleaned the surface again. I have sprayed disinfectant on the surface and I have cleaned my cutting equipments, everything. I have cleaned my hands. Now I will spray 3% hydrogen peroxide nicely on the orchid. You can use 3% solution as it is, no need to dilute it. I have transferred the some of this into a small spray bottle and I will spray the plant. Some fizzing noise, that's good. That means that the hydrogen peroxide is working. Once the fizz is over, that means the hydrogen peroxide has done its work, and all that is left is just water. You can wipe off the excess water with a clean paper towel. At this point, if you want, you can apply a fungicide. I don't have any. I will use cinnamon. It works great for me. With a paint brush, I will apply cinnamon on the cut ends of the leaves and also a little here in this crown portion. It's dry and healed. Still no harm in putting some. And also, I don't use 3% hydrogen peroxide for all my regular repotting. I just use this for the plants with infection and all. Now I will leave this for a couple of hours and deal with the other minifalls. Once the cinnamon is dry and nicely stuck to the cut ends, I will mount this one. You can pot it as well. I prefer mounting because it works great in humid climate like mine. And my mounted falls, they are really thriving very nicely. It will be easier for me to maintain this one along with my other mounted orchids. I will mount it in a downward angle so that water won't stay on the leaves or the crown for too long. It will simply trickle down. I have this beautiful terracotta saucer that I bought for 20 rupees from my local market. And I have made some holes on it. Now I will lay a layer of moss, place the orchid on top of it, and once it's placed properly at the desired angle, I will cover these roots with a little bit of moss and secure it to the mount. Tying is very easy. I will pass a thread through the holes in a crisscross manner and go on doing it till my orchid is stable. Once it holds well in its place, I will tie a knot behind to finish the whole thing. So we are done now. My fall is stable. I will hang it in a shaded window with lots of ventilation for a few days. And then I'll move it to my balcony to a slightly brighter spot after about a week. In the meanwhile, I will spray water on the root portion on every alternate day. Once I see the plant is stable, no new weird looking spots or other issues, then I will start spraying the roots daily. No fertilizer till I see new roots. That will be somewhere around 2 to 3 weeks from now. After that, I will use my liquid seaweed extract and Epsom salt for this. You can watch my mounted orchid care video for more info on how I maintain my mounted orchids. I will leave the link in the description box and also here in the info card. I have treated the other mildly affected one and the other rest of the mini falls. I have unpotted, cleaned and mounted them on this terracotta piece. Similar care for this as well. We'll keep watching daily for any new spots and we'll go on removing infected tissue and spraying hydrogen peroxide if new spots appear. I don't want to introduce any infection into my healthy orchids if at all any infection is left after treating. So for a month or so, I will keep them away from my other orchids. And if I don't notice any new spots, if the plants they do well, then I will introduce them to my collection and they will grow along with my other orchids. So that's all for today, friends. I hope you like this video, and if you do, then please keep supporting. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video. Everything is absolutely free. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.